9 subject matter experts assessed commercially available battery-powered rescue tools for vehicle extrication, specifically cutters and spreaders that can be used by first responders to save victims entrapped in or by a vehicle. These products were assessed against manufacturer-provided specifications and while performing simulated operational activities at General Motors Milford Proving Ground in Michigan from October 25th through 27th, 2022. This assessment was conducted by the SAVER program. SAVER is managed by the National Urban Security Technology Laboratory, or NewSteel, part of the Department of Homeland Security's Science and Technology Directorate. Evaluators assessed 3 cutters and 3 spreaders after a familiarization session for each tool that included a discussion of manufacturer-provided specifications and use of the product in 2 operational scenarios. During the undamaged vehicle scenario, evaluators responded to a call in which an occupant was reported to be unresponsive in a locked, undamaged vehicle. Evaluators approached the vehicle and determined immediate extrication was required. They began gaining access to the vehicle by first cutting the doors and then the pillars. During the rollover vehicle scenario, evaluators responded to a call of a rolled over vehicle, leaving the occupant trapped and hanging upside down while secured by their seatbelt. After approaching the vehicle and assessing the conditions, evaluators stabilized the vehicle. Once stabilized, they began the extrication process, starting with the cutters. When evaluators determined their cuts were sufficient, they used spreaders to expand the vehicle's doors, trunks, or roofs, allowing them to access and safely remove the occupant. The subject matter expert evaluators assessed each cutter against a total of 22 evaluation criteria within the 5 SAVER categories. Capability at 30%, usability at 30%, affordability at 20%, maintainability at 15%, and deployability at 5%. The Hurst S789E3 received an overall score of 4.2. The box cut design blades cut and compress metal without causing the tool to pivot, giving it a high score in the capability category. Evaluators also appreciated that the S789E3 included an additional battery life indicator display on the back of the tool, enhancing situational awareness for those on scene. One disadvantage identified was how the placement of LED lights is not ideal, as an operator's hands would partially cover them, limiting visibility. The Holmatro Pentheon PCU50 received an overall score of 4.0. The cutter was found to be well-balanced due to the curved battery, battery placement, and rear handle, and evaluators stated that the front handle and control throttle in the rear were easy to use. However, evaluators expressed concerns that the bar in the middle of the 360-degree carrying handle does not offer sufficient space to fit gloved hands to carry the tool in a natural and comfortable fashion, and that the non-recessed power button could cause an accidental shutoff. The Genesis C236 SL3 E-Force received an overall score of 3.5. The availability of next-gen blade cutting inserts were seen as an advantage to evaluators, as they could increase performance and be easier to replace than the full cutter blades. Additionally, the control level or throttle was found to be in an ideal location for operations. However, evaluators found the tool to be unbalanced due to the length and design of the back end. Evaluators also said the cutter's adjustable handle further detracted from ergonomics, as the locking mechanism resulted in continued movement during use in transportation. The subject matter expert evaluators assessed each spreader against a total of 21 evaluation criteria within the 5 SAVER categories. Capability at 30%, usability at 30%, affordability at 20%, maintainability at 15%, and deployability at 5%. The Hurst SP555E3 received an overall score of 4.3. Evaluators noted that the star grip valve or throttle allows the users to operate the spreader in any position. Additionally, they found the brightness, layout, position, and comprehensive visual display of the spreader to be advantageous. The SP555E3 had the same disadvantages identified as the cutter, as evaluators observe that the placement of the LED lights on top of the tool is less than ideal, as an operator's hands could partially obscure the LED lights, limiting visibility. The Holmatro Pentheon PSP40 received an overall score of 4.0. Evaluators also found the spreader to be well balanced due to the curved battery, battery placement, and rear handle. Additionally, they valued that the tool stopped when it reached maximum pressure to prevent it from being overworked. The PSP-40 had the same disadvantages identified as the cutter, as evaluators expressed concerns that the bar in the middle of the 360-degree carrying handle does not offer sufficient space to fit a gloved hand to carry the tool in a natural and comfortable fashion, and that the non-recessed power button could cause an accidental shutoff. The Genesis S49 SL3 eForce received an overall score of 3.5. Evaluators found the spreader intuitive to use and appreciated that the trigger button's static position made it easy to know which way the tool was moving. The tool had the same disadvantages as the cutter, as evaluators found it to be unbalanced due to the length and design of the back end, and the adjustable handle further detracted from ergonomics as the locking mechanism resulted in continued movement during use and transportation. To learn more about the capability, deployability, usability, maintainability, and affordability of these products, access the full battery-powered rescue tools for vehicle extrication assessment report at the Saver website. New Steel Saver program provides information on commercially available technology and equipment that first responder agencies can use to make informed operational and procurement decisions. More information on the Saver program and access to more than 1,000 first responder-focused reports can be found at the Saver website. New Steel thanks the assessment evaluators for their valuable time and expertise, specifically the Chicago Fire Department, the Dallas Fire Rescue Department, Denver Fire Department, Hearst Fire Department, Loudoun County Fire and Rescue, New York City Fire Department, and the United States Secret Service. Their insights and recommendations will assist responder agencies in making procurement decisions. Appreciation is also extended to the General Motors Proving Ground for hosting the event, and for Michigan State Police for helping with coordination.